And that's fine. I'm not saying that you have to. I'm
Right.
just saying, no matter what you do, you're going to have haters.
Yeah.
I'm Mother Teresa has haters.
Hey, it's Lance McGowan here and
Tanner Freakard.
And today we're going to be talking about how to handle skepticism, adversity, objections, haters, whatever you want to call it, because if you're doing something with your life, you're going to get that, period. From family members, business partners, spouses, significant others, maybe kids, strangers, commenters on social media, people in the line at Starbucks or fast food place. It don't matter. They're going to come out, and it's important for us to be able to handle it. And some learnings that I have on that, one of the ways that I kind of handle that is I think about the movie 8 Mile with Eminem in it. And if you haven't seen it, basically he was in a rap battle and he was able to take all the words out of his opponent's mouth by just saying them first. He was like, yes, I'm poor, yes, you slept with my girlfriend, yes, you know, this and this and this. And the other person at the end of all that was speechless. They literally had nothing to say, and Eminem won that rap battle. And not that it's about winning or losing, but it is about being able to understand what your opponent's going to say,
true,
or what the haters are going to say, and be able to really just address it before it's spoken. And so another thing that I've learned is providing social proof is important, because a lot of people don't associate credibility or even authority to someone that they don't like or agree with.
Yeah.
That's a harder road to go down. But if they're still, maybe neutral about a person or message, then yeah, maybe seeing their follower count or client count or having somebody else give a referral to them, those are ways to build that social proof. And then I like what Gary Vee says, and he's like, because somebody, like on one of his keynotes, somebody asked like, hey, what do you do with haters? Like, what do you do when people hate on you or just totally diss you or don't like you? And he's like, I do two things. One is I extend empathy, because he tries to put himself in the other person's position. Is like, if they're giving that much negativity and toxicity, they're not in a good place. And I try to understand where that place is. But the other thing he says is I try to have gratefulness that I'm not in that place. And by not being in that place of negativity, and he also added a third thing, which is he understands what his intentions are. His intentions are to help business owners get to the next level or get past roadblocks or develop a positive belief system or add value or storytell, or he's all about being able to do more with less. And he says he day trades attention, right? He goes to the most underpriced forms of attention where people are hanging out at and tries to offer value there. And if a hater, is coming from a bad place and doesn't understand his intentions, Gary knows that he's not there. And so he's not in that negative space. He's in a positive place. And his intentions are to help.
True.
And to add value, whether the other person agrees, likes, or sees it or not.
Yes.
And I think that's so powerful and some things that I've learned with regards to skepticism, objections, and all that.
I say if you don't have any haters, then you're not doing anything.
Truly,
there's no good deed that you can possibly do that someone's not going to try to rain on your parade simply because they didn't think of it first, or, maybe they don't have the guts to go out and do something. And we're probably going to get a lot of hate on this as well. And that's okay, because it allows people to engage and have a voice. Mm-hmm. And that's really what they're doing. They're sharing their side of the story. And that's why I love what Gary says, is he has empathy. He's passionate about the people who are unwilling to do anything for themselves, so they're just going to complain about everything that everyone else is doing. And yeah, it's true. If you don't like something, do something about it. I hear this with politics all the time, and I don't talk politics at all because it's just... there's no good way of going about it. But my perspective on it is, if you don't like how someone is doing something, why don't you go do something about it? And if you're not going to do anything about it, might as well just stop talking about it or shut up. Because if you're not going to actually help, then you're just as bad, if not worse, than the person who's doing something about it. They might not be doing the right things or the things that you think are best and what we need, but if you're not going to actually help the situation, then what the heck are you doing?
Yeah, and some very, like in the political realm, I know one of my business partners challenged someone else about that was, are you, like, there's a few things that you could practically do
yeah.
instead of complaining about the political situation. You can boycott.
Yeah.
You can do peaceful sit-ins.
True.
You can start a nonprofit that focuses on educating others.
Yeah.
You can do YouTube, you can do blogs, and if they're focused on education and being objective and showing both sides and then ultimately what you would do, I think it's good. But if it's just the whole negative bashing session with negative, you know, and a bunch of stuff, I don't think that adds value. That's just
no.
more venting. But if it is objective and saying, here's both sides and here's the pros and cons of both sides, but ultimately here's why I choose this side or that side, I think that's educational value besides boycotting or positive sit-ins
yeah.
or peaceful sit-ins. And those are very practical things that someone can do besides
Absolutely.
Complaining. But that requires effort. That requires execution.
Yeah.
And a lot of people are lazy. I mean, just to be blunt. And they just, it's so much easier to complain.
It's and
so
it's easy to hide behind something else. It's easy to hide behind a comment. It's easy to
sure.
hide behind stuff. But it's hard to actually do something.
Yeah.
You know, because it requires that effort. It requires energy. It requires research in understanding what it is that you're going to talk about. And most of the time, people would rather not do those things, but voice their opinion on matters that they have no knowledge of, no education on, and they don't really care to know any of those things. And that's fine. I'm not saying that you have to.
Right.
I'm just saying, no matter what you do, you're going to have haters.
Yeah.
You know, Mother Teresa has haters. And she's the one of the most blessed and wonderful people on the planet. I mean, even Jesus had haters.
That's right.
He had tons of them, but he was doing something. And that when the more you do, the more haters that you're going to have. If you can't handle people not enjoying 100% making everybody happy, then you're probably not in the right industries.
Yeah.
You're not doing the right things because you have to have something that we call mental toughness, which is why I love this book.
Hey,
get this book. It's called 177 Mental Toughnesses of the World Class. Super easy to read. You read about a chapter a day, but it talks about all these different things about what the pros do and what the amateurs do and what the world class does. You know, the world class, they understand that not everybody is going to enjoy or like what they do. Not everyone's going to enjoy or like what, what's his name, the golf player?
Tiger Woods.
Tiger Woods. Yeah, I just say golf player and you automatically know who I'm talking about, right? Because he's that good in his field.
Mm.
But yet, he has had several scandals. He's had several things. But you know what his coaches said? You know, they said, I hate the fact that he went and apologized. Because it showed weakness. It shows that he cared about what people said. And that's why he had people that pulled out. Now, and I'm not agreeing with what he did at all. I'm not agreeing with any. I frown upon all the aspects of what he did as a person.
Some of the infidelity.
Moral. Yes, and
yeah.
all of those
yeah.
things. I am a huge... That, no, don't do any of that stuff. So don't take that. I'm on his side by any means. But what I am on the side of is they said, you know what? Go win another championship or two, and all of that stuff goes away.
That's true, yeah.
You know, the only reason, like when you go into your haters' world and try to please them, all they're going to do is bring you down even further. It's like you're trying to save somebody who's drowning. You know, I don't know if you've ever seen any of the SEALs movies or anything where someone's drowning and they jump in the water to help get them out and they start dragging them down too. And that's why they end up breaking their nose or breaking something or knocking them out so that they don't die themselves.
Wow.
And yes, it's probably a little overboard in occasions, but it's what they need to snap out of that so that you can drag them to safety so that you can get them back on land where they're going to be profitable, where they're going to be successful, where they're going to enjoy what it is that they want versus the lifestyle that they're in.